Sounds good.
Back off the mic. Okay. Okay.
I'm gonna chill for my.
Okay.
And no, oh good, wow, that's red.
Really bonks us out.
One, two, three. One, two, three.
Thank you.
Good evening and welcome. Welcome, everybody. Good evening and welcome. Before we begin tonight's Mass, we have a few announcements. Please join in all the singing and responses during Mass. The lyrics and responses can be found in your worship aid. We will begin with a procession of our graduates and faculty, followed by a welcome address by our principal, Ms. Michelle Levine. Thank you for joining us tonight.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Michelle Nevin Levine, and I'm the principal of St. Ignatius College Preparatory. It is my pleasure to welcome you all to the Baccalaureate Mass for the class of 2022. This year, the theme of our school year is Journeying with Ignatius. We have focused on the life of Ignatius and how he models pausing, reflecting, and discerning. Ignatius wrestled with how he was called to respond to a complex, beautiful, and struggling world. As a school community, we have learned to navigate the uncertainties of the world and have worked hard to come back to full life at SI, a life that cultivates and nourishes joy. Each of you, the St. Ignatius graduating class of 2022, have helped to lead our community this year with love and openness to growth. You have lived out the spirit of St. Ignatius in and outside of the classroom. Thank you. Tonight we are gathered in this sacred space as an opportunity to celebrate the friendships, accomplishments, and gifts of the past 4 years. We ask that you participate in the liturgy by following along with our worship aid and by singing. In place of applauding after parts of the liturgy, please show your gratitude by joining your voices with our choir. Let us now all stand to begin the 2022 Baccalaureate Mass, and let us sing our opening song, How Great is Our God.
Beginning and superior of the Jesuit community, and I work in the adult spirituality department. Unfortunately, Father Reese tested positive a few days ago, and so here I am. And he's recovering nicely. His symptoms have been mild. And so we pray together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of their Holy Spirit be with you. We gather together as God's holy people, also God's sinful people. And so we pray and ask forgiveness of a loving God. Lord Jesus, you came to reconcile us to one another. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you heal the wounds of sin and division. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray.
O God, who gave one origin to all peoples and willed to gather them into one family,
all hearts with the fire of your love, and kindle in them a desire for the just advancement of their neighbor, that through the good things which you richly bestow upon all, each human person may be brought to authenticity, every division may be removed, and equity and justice may be established in human society. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. What is the manner of fasting that I, the Lord your God, would choose? Is it not releasing those bound unjustly, untying the thongs of the yoke, setting free the oppressed, breaking off every yoke? Is it not sharing your bread with the hungry, bringing the afflicted and homeless into your house, clothing the naked when you see them, and not turning your back on your own flesh? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. Then you shall call, and the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am." If you remove the yoke from among you, the accusing finger, the malicious speech, if you lavish your food on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom shall become like the midday. Then the Lord will guide you always and satisfy your thirst in parched places, will give you strength to your bones, and you shall be like a watered garden, like a flowing spring whose waters never fail. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Disconnected and reconnected.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, thirsting for you, my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Rejoice in the Lord always. I shall say it again, rejoice. Your kindness should be known to all. The Lord is near. Have no anxiety at all, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. Then the peace of the God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence and if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. Whoever loves me keeps my word. And my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Those who do not love me do not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord. Let me, working? No, it's, yes, no, yes. Message. The gospel passage I just read, it's from John's presentation of the Last Supper. It's the farewell discourse of Jesus, bidding farewell, basically, to his followers. So it's an appropriate gospel for today, isn't it, as we attend the penultimate gathering of the class of 2022. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. When Jesus refers to his own commandments, we immediately think of those two basic commandments, don't we? Love God and love your neighbor as yourself. St. Ignatius, we're in his church, we attended his school, he had something to say about love. It's typically pithy. Love should be manifest more in deeds than in words. In contemporary life, we probably say, if you're gonna talk the talk, then you gotta walk the walk. And I think Isaiah had the same idea. In that first reading, set free the oppressed, break every yoke, share your bread with the hungry, clothe the naked. In his letter to the Philippians, Paul puts it somewhat differently and generally, your kindness should be known to all. Isaiah continues saying that if indeed you share your bread, if indeed you clothe the naked, then when you call out, God will be there. God will hear you. He also says it in the words, if you cry out for help, God will say, I am here. I am here. When do we cry out? When do we call upon God? Over the years, I've had occasion to ask many high school students, college students, adults, when do they pray? And the common response often enough is, when I'm lying in bed at night. It's the perfect atmosphere for that, isn't it? There's a stillness, there's a quiet, there's darkness. Even if you share a room, you feel like you're in your own personal cocoon. And it's then that you think of your day. It's then that you think about tomorrow. It's sort of like an examine, reflecting upon your life, where you've been and where you're going. And when you speak to God about what's in your heart and what's occupying your mind, God says to you, I am here. Most often, of course, you do that lying in your own bed at home. That's going to change in a few months. Most of you are going to be off where? Across the country? A few hundred miles away, maybe? Wherever. In a dorm room? In a frat or sorority house? In an apartment on or off campus? That's where you will lie in bed at night. And you can be assured God's already there waiting for you. Waiting for you to lie in your bed at night and tell you, I am here. This past year, it's been chaotic. Senior year is always hectic. And you wonder, how are you going to get everything done that you have to get done? It's not only schoolwork, it's clubs, it's teams, it's social activities. It's this constant. And so you came to treasure when your head actually hit the pillow and you had a few moments of quiet to yourself. Let me tell you, that's going to change in about 3 months, too. And if you thought it was fast then, it'll be faster. I'm reminded of an old line from the actress Betty Davis. Fasten your seatbelts, it's going to be a bumpy ride tonight. It'll be bumpy. Bumpy with excitement, bumpy with challenges, bumpy with, oh my God, how am I going to do it? And God will be there with you. God will be there with you. I am reminded of, at the end of my freshman year at Santa Clara, there were five or six of us gathered in a dorm room. We were just reflecting on the year. And one of the guys said, you know, in this past year, I've learned more than I did in the 4 years of high school. And most of us agreed. It's amazing how you are able to focus and be attentive and to do things, and to be active, and to be involved. And so when your head hits the pillow at night, a few months from now, you're going to say, oh, thank God. And that's about the only prayer you got, and you'll be asleep. But know that God is there. Know that wherever you go, whatever the circumstances, whether you're excited about what's happening or whether you're concerned about a test or a paper or a relationship, if you cry out for help, and if you do indeed feed the hungry, take care of those who are naked and clothe them, if you reach out and are kind to others, then God will say to you, I am here. Please stand. We gather as a community that has shared joys and sorrows, learning and much growth. Inspired by the promise of the gospel, let us express our hope in prayers for ourselves and our world.
For the church, that we may continue to be the light of Christ and speak out for human dignity and human rights, we pray to the Lord. For local, national, and world leaders, may they recognize the harms of war, racism, and divisiveness, and work toward lasting peace and justice, we pray to the Lord. For those experiencing homelessness, addiction, and illness, especially those affected by the coronavirus, may God ease their struggle, bring hope to their hearts, and show them a path to a new beginning. We pray to the Lord. For our friends and families who love us, care for our needs, listen to and comfort us, advise us, and by their selflessness, bring us closer to God. We pray to the Lord.
For the faculty, staff, benefactors, and Jesuit community at SI, that they would continue to instill our Jesuit Catholic values in the student body, promoting and encouraging an environment where we can flourish as persons with and for others. We pray to the Lord. For the freshmen, sophomores, and juniors at SI, that they would have the courage and strength to continue to be servant leaders as they move into the next year of their SI experience. We pray to the Lord. For the SI class of 2022, that we would embrace each challenge that may meet us in the future, and that we would act lovingly in accord with our formation while moving on to the next stage in our lives. We pray to the Lord. For all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Loving God, you have created and redeemed us all. As we continue in thanksgiving for the blessings of a high school career, may our faith bear fruit in our lives and our works of justice and charity glorify your name. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen. We are Ignatians, with and for others, with and for each other. As we express the joy of belonging to this community, let's also open our hearts, minds, and hands to those who experience any kind of exclusion.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Yes, wait 15 seconds.
So
please be seated. Now that we have extended Christ's peace to one another, let us remember the gifts God has given us that we now place on the altar.
You dwell in the songs that we are singing, rising to the heavens, rising to your heart, our praises filling up the spaces in between your frailty and everything you are. You are the keeper of my heart. Whisper in the dark, 'cause I know you're more than my salvation. Without you, I'm hopeless. Tell me who you are. You are the keeper of my heart. And I'm
rest.
acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Hear, O Lord, in your mercy the prayers of those who cry to you, and as you receive your church's offering, grant that all may be filled with the spirit of divine sonship, so that with inequalities overcome by charity, our family of peoples may be formed in your peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through him you brought us to the knowledge of your truth, so that by the bond of one faith and one baptism, we might become his body. Through him you poured out your Holy Spirit among all the nations, so that in a wondrous manner he might prompt and engender unity in the diversity of your gifts, dwelling within your adopted children and filling and ruling the whole church. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Ignatius Loyola, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant us peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our hope, of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy, tried and true, with thanksgiving. I'll be a living sanctuary for you.
All are invited to participate in our communion procession as a sign of unity. If you are not Catholic or are not personally prepared to receive communion, please come forward and cross your arms over your chest if you would like to receive a blessing from the Eucharistic minister.
I come to you, let my heart be changed, renewed, flowing from the grace that I found in you. Lord, I've
Let your love
our lives for a reason, bringing something we must learn.
And we are glad to those who help us most to grow if we let them, and we help them in return.
Well, I don't know if I believe that's true, but I know I'm who I am today because I knew you.
Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes a sun, like a stream that meets a boulder halfway through the wood. Who can say if I've been changed for the better? But because I knew you, I have been changed for good.
It well may be that we will never meet again in this lifetime. So let me say before we part,
so much of me is made of what I learned from you.
You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart.
Please remain seated. Let us pray. Having been fed with your word and spirit by which you constantly renew the human family, we pray, O Lord, that from participation in this celebration of unity, we may draw a love strong and pure to help all people in their development and prompted by charity to fulfill what justice requires, we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. I would like now to welcome Jackie Acosta to lead the senior class prayer.
Would my fellow members of the class of 2022 please stand? St. Ignatius, in his spiritual exercises, invites us to find God in all things. We have found God in each other and in so many events of our high school career. As we pray in thanksgiving for our past 4 years together as friends, let us also pray for each other's future journey. For one last time together, let us slowly and intentionally pray the prayer we all know so well, the prayer of generosity. Lord, teach me to be generous. Teach me to serve you as you deserve, to give and not count the cost, to fight and not heed the wounds, to toil and not seek for rest, to labor and not seek reward. Save that knowing that I'm doing your will. Amen. St. Ignatius.
There are many people to thank tonight for our final Mass for the academic year. I ask that you please hold your applause until I've read all of the people. We are especially grateful to the priests and the staff here at St. Ignatius Church, to Chris Wemp and Bill Vaughn for being our wonderful accompanists, for all the students and adults who were involved in the liturgical planning for this celebration, including campus ministry, student activities, communications, and our Jesuit community, Father Stiegler, and Father Clemo. For all of these, let us offer a warm round of applause. I ask the graduates to remain seated and everyone else to stand. Let us pray for God's blessing for the graduates of the St. Ignatius class of 2022. All present are asked to please extend your arms and hands and join me in this blessing. Loving God, we thank you for guiding these Ignatians and for the work that has led to their graduation. Bless them and open their hearts to trust your light on the path that lies before them. May their next steps in college and career be fruitful and valuable. And may all their efforts build up your kingdom, where you live with Jesus and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Graduates, please stand. The Lord be with you. Please bow your heads for God's blessing. May God bless you and keep you. Amen. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Amen. May God look upon you with kindness and give you peace. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
A river runs through all of us, flowing to the sun.
Oh.